In this video, we're gonna have a look at the Silverado ZR2 and the Toyota Tundra TRD Pro. Compare the two, then I'm gonna let you know which one I would buy. So let's start with the Toyota Tundra here. It's powered by a hybrid V6 that makes 437 horsepower, max payload is 1,600 pounds, and it can tow 11,175 pounds. It also comes with a 1.1-inch lift, rear locking diff, front stabilizer and skid plate, low-speed crawl control, all-terrain 33-inch Falcon tires, and a 14-inch infotainment screen, which is the biggest in the business. You can get this TRD Pro at a starting price of around $67,500. On the other side in the ring, you have the 2022 all-new Silverado ZR2. We haven't seen a ZR2 spec or trim for the Silverado up until this year. It gets a 420 horsepower 6.2 liter V8 and a 10-speed automatic. Max payload for the Silverado ZR2 is 1,440 pounds, and it can tow 8,900 pounds compared to the over 11,000 for the Tundra. So that's one thing to keep in mind here. We also have a 2-inch lift from factory, front and rear lockers, one pedal rock crawling, and 33-inch Goodyear Wrangler off-road tires and front skid plates. The infotainment screen is not as big as the Tundra's with the 14-inch for the Tundra. The Silverado ZR2 has a 13.4-inch infotainment screen, as if that really matters. They're both huge. I think that's the key point here. And you can get a Silverado ZR2 for $70,200, which is a little bit more expensive than the TRD Pro. Now, let's jump in to the design and let's compare these two beasts of machines. I really like both of these, to be honest. If I were actually to buy one of these, it would be a really tough choice. Specifically when you think about the payload and the towing is higher for the Tundra, but the price sits lower as well. But looking at the front end, I think this is always going to be, you know, the front end is always the face and the personality of a vehicle. And I really do like the new updated Tundra. I do still think that the bumper looks a little too heavy. It kind of brings the mass down a little, maybe too much for my taste. It looks too bulky. But in this red, it looks a lot better than when we have the, for example, I know there's a lot of the normal trim levels for the Tundra has this chrome, this piece in chrome. So you have like a chrome frame around this grille, and I think it doesn't look as good as having it body colored like we have here. You also have this, a light bar, which I think is really cool to have from factory, because usually what people do, myself on my Rebel, I put a light bar in the front as an aftermarket piece, but here you get it actually integrated pretty nicely in the grille. It kind of sits inside of this mesh here nicely, and it looks like it's belongs there. And then you have the big Toyota letters up here, which I also love, which goes back to the 70s and the 80s. We have new headlights for the Tundra, as you can see. What I like about these headlights is that they follow the shape of the fender. So this line that we have in the fender now goes into the LED itself, and then the LED curves down, and then it goes into this line as well that then continues into the fender. So it's a clean design, and I like the flow of the front end. It's very geometrical still. It should be. It's a huge truck, so I don't have anything against the geometric features, and I do like how they implemented some kind of line flow in there in the front end. Well done for the upgrade of the Tundra. Now let's have a look at the Silverado. I really like what they did here. They kept the majority of the old styling of the Silverado, but this update, this is just one of these perfect facelifts in my opinion. The reason being, I've said this before, I didn't think it had enough of a clear identity in the front end, specifically talking about this. The LEDs in front, they were so thin on the old one that you could barely tell what it is. You can barely see them at night. Now they're massive. They really adjusted the width and the thickness of this LED. And I think it looks so much better. It's definitely gonna give it more of a presence, specifically looking at it at night. Then you have a massive black front fascia, and you have these cuts in the bumper for the ZR2 trim to have a better approach angle for the tire. You have the red tow hooks, you have the skid plate in the bottom in silver, which I think looks great color-wise. It kind of complements the front end. You also have these lights in here, which I don't really know what they're there for, but I'm not complaining because I think lights like this, lights in the front end, it makes up for a nice face, and these additional tiny lights in the front end, it kind of makes it look cool. You also have a hollow logo here for airflow going in here, and I don't know how much more of a percentage more air the engine is gonna get with this being hollow, but I think, yeah, I guess it has a function for the functionality of the truck. Still a cool detail specifically for the ZR2 trim. Let's have a look at the side view, and this I think is where they stand the most apart, these two trucks. I really like the Silverado in this case, because the reason is we don't have this any flow from the Tundra. It looks very boxy from the side, which some people like in a truck like this, and I totally get that. But for if it was me, I prefer a little more styling between these two boxes. So we have box number 1, 2, and 3, as you can see right here. And I want to have some connection more between these. And then we have these widened fenders with these top level or shelf up here on both the front and the rear, which I think kind of compartmentalizes these boxes even more and doesn't look like they connect to each other in a nice or flowing way. But it still looks very, very functional. I'm still a fan of what they did to the Tundra with this design. What I really like is, we're gonna have a look at the rear view, is the rear bumper, but more on that in just a second. What I definitely would do if I got any of these trucks, these are 33 inch, and I kind of think that they look maybe a little too small for the wheelhouses. I think one of the reasons for that specifically on the Tundra is that we have these black plastic cladding here, which makes it look like the wheel, the hole for the wheelhouse is bigger than what it actually is. This looks like it's hollow and part of the hole for the wheel. So it looks like the wheel is ending here and the hole for the wheelhouse is ending up here. So this is a huge distance between the wheel and the visual endpoint of the wheelhouses. So I would definitely put at least 35s on this truck. So let's have a look at the Silverado and the flow that I'm talking about. One line that I love on the Silverado is this line right here that cuts into the body and then goes into the shoulder line, as you can see right here. We also have another line, which is the shoulder, the proper shoulder line up top, that cuts from the bed, from box number 3, clearly into box number 2 right here. And we also have the connection now from box number 1 in the front going into clearly intruding right here on the box number 2, as you can see right there. And it creates a nice styling. It creates a fluid line from the front box to the box number 2. It makes it look beautiful, in my opinion. That's not an easy thing to do with a big truck like this. I don't know why, but the wheels in this case, these are the same size, these Goodyear Wrangler wheels, they are also 33 inches, but for some reason, I don't know, let me hide this and let me show you exactly what I mean. I think it has to do maybe with the aggressive pattern of the Goodyear Wranglers compared to the Falcon tires. They just look bigger. I don't know if you agree with me, let me know in the comments below, but they look like they fill out the wheelhouses way better than it does on the Tundra. So if I were to get the Silverado, I probably would just keep these 33-inch wheels because I think they look great on the Silverado. Before we jump into the interior, let's quickly have a look at the rear views of these trucks as well. So up here we have the TRD Pro Tundra, down here the Silverado, obviously, as you can see. And what I think about the TRD is that it looks pretty static in the rear because the taillight doesn't have a clear direction to it. There, it has the same design in the bottom part that it has in the top, which doesn't pull it either up or down. So it looks like a static piece that's on the rear end. But what I really like about the Tundra truck is that they decided to design the bumper, the entire bumper, they decided to design this in-house and not use a third party to supply the bumpers for them, which is what usually happens when you design trucks and specifically commercial vans and so on. But other than that, it's a pretty decent, cool looking design. I like these graphics that we have in the tailgate, as you can see, some camo styling in the bumper and up here as well. We also have some styling in the tailgate here with these lines. You can see this line going in. than housing the handle for the tailgate. Looking pretty cool in my opinion. So it's functional, but still has a clear identity to it for the Tundra. Looking at the Silverado ZR2 down here, here you can clearly see that this is one of these third-party bumpers that is supplied by another company and not designed in-house. I think this looks really good as well. This has this truck feel to it. Well, this has this more like unibody feel to the rear end. I don't know which one you prefer, it's all a matter of taste, but if I were to pick one, I'm gonna have to go with the Silverado right here. Last but not least, let's have a look at the interiors here, because these are the big changes for both of these trucks. You have the Tundra up here with the 14-inch screen, which is the biggest one in this segment. And it is it's a TV that you have right in the center. And I love this red trim. This is something I would definitely get on my Tundra if I were ordering this car. I love this embossed Toyota stamped into the passenger side right there. And this as well, the centerpiece, the center red line for the steering wheel. I love the design of the steering wheel as well. Very functional, geometric, while still keeping it looking modern and fresh with some styling cues with the buttons and the TRD logo at the bottom right here. Looking at the pedals, we have aluminum pedals here, which is another benefit for the Tundra. And it just looks like a very, very cozy place to be in. It looks like a place that I want to sit and drive for a very long time. And you have the same camo as well shown in the rear. You have that same pattern right here on the seats, which adds another layer of personality to the interior of the Tundra. Looking at the Silverado ZR2 down here, same thing with this truck. I think it looks absolutely gorgeous in the interior. I think the infotainment screen is a lot better implemented or integrated in the design that we have in the Toyota. I'd rather have it horizontal like this. A little smaller with 13.4 inches right here, but looking at this interior and comparing it to the previous pre-facelift Silverado, it's like they stepped forward by 20-25 years. It looks super clean and super cozy, nice. The quality of the interior, just by looking at it, looks like it stepped it up by 100% compared to the pre-facelift generation. And both of these gauge clusters, both in the Tundra and the Silverado, are now digital as well. We don't have any center point or center line for the steering wheel like we have in the Tundra. It looks like the pedals are pretty standard as well. No aluminum pedals down here. But overall, I think both of these trucks have done a fantastic job updating the Tundra and the Silverado. So which one of these would I buy? That's such a tough choice. Just based on the design, I would definitely go for the Silverado. That's more my style personally, specifically looking at it in the front end. But then you need to think about spec and tech of these cars, and also of these trucks, and also the price. The Tundra sitting at about $2,500, $3,000 less than the Silverado ZR2. And ZR2 is coming out with a Bison version that's going to be even more off-road capable than this. And the Tundra, even though it's cheaper, can also tow more and have a higher payload than the Silverado. But still, if I were to buy any of these cars, I would rather go with a V8. Although a little less power than the Tundra, but it's still a V8, so you have that nice rumble noise. If it was me, I would go for the Silverado ZR2 in this case. Let me know which one you would pick and why in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.